Welcome. You may wonder, is there a general recipe that tells you how to solve a given equation? The answer is, unfortunately, no. But as you have seen in the previous videos of this week, there are techniques that you can use to attack equations and several good habits that help you avoid making mistakes. Given an equation, the following steps are important to solve it. Simplify the equation to a form that you know how to solve. Solve it and identify the solutions, and then check your solutions. In this video, I'd like to give you a general overview of these steps and summarize techniques and issues that we have encountered. To solve an equation, the main step is to simplify or reduce it to a form that you know how to solve. The idea is to transform the equation into one or several simpler equations in such a way that any solution to the new equations is also a solution to the old equation. Let's look at some strategies. The main strategy is sometimes called the balance method. Perform the same operation on both sides to simplify the equation. Let me give you a list of examples of common operations. Add or subtract the same term on both sides. In the example, we can add 3 to both sides and solve the equation. Divide by a common factor. In the example, we can divide by 1 plus square root of x. Multiply to get rid of denominators. Here, we can multiply by 1 plus x squared. Square to get rid of square roots, and more generally, to get rid of a standard function like power functions, apply its inverse if it exists. Here we use that the cube root is the inverse of the cube function. I would like to add some warnings. Be careful if you divide by a common factor. In the example, we were divided by 1 plus square root of x. This is possible since 1 plus square root of x is non-zero for all x. But consider the example x times x minus 4 equals 5 times x minus 4. As long as x minus 4 is non-zero, you can cancel this factor and obtain x equal to 5. This is a solution. But don't forget the possibility x minus 4 equal to 0, that is, x equal to 4. This is a solution as well. In general, if your equation has the form a times c equals b times c, where a, b and c are certain expressions, then you can simplify this to a equal to b or c equal to 0. Furthermore, be careful if you want to invert the function. In the example, we could get rid of the cube by applying a cube root. No problem there. But be careful when it comes to squares. For example, consider the equation x squared equal to x minus 2 squared. I've seen many students make the following mistake. To get rid of the square, we take the square root on both sides and end up with x equal to x minus 2, which has no solution. But there is a solution, namely x equal to 1, as you can check. So what's the problem here? Well, we are trying to get rid of the square function by applying an inverse function, but the square function is not invertible. In general, if a squared equal to b squared for some expressions a and b, then either a equal to b or a equal to minus b. If you forget the second, you may miss solutions. So in the example, we have to add a possibility x equal to 2 minus x, which indeed has x equal to 1 as a solution. Let's move on to other simplification strategies. You have already seen factorization. For example, the equation x squared minus 5x plus 4 can be written as x minus 1 times x minus 4 equal to 0. This implies that either x minus 1 equals 0 or x minus 4 equals 0, hence x equal to 1 or x equal to 4. This method is not limited to quadratic equations. In general, the following holds. If you can rewrite your equation as a times b equal to 0, then either a equal to 0 or b is equal to 0. Of course, this is only possible if a times b is 0. For other constants, there is no easy way to factorize. The last technique I'd like to mention is substitution. Let me show you an example. Consider the equation x to the power 6 minus 3 times x cubed minus 4 equal to 0. This is a high degree polynomial equation. However, we can rewrite it as follows. Note that x always occurs with a third power. Now we introduce a new variable, p equal to x cubed. We can rewrite the equation in terms of p. p squared minus 3p minus 4 equals 0. We call this substitution. This is a quadratic equation which you can solve using your favorite method. We obtain two solutions, p equal to minus 1 or p equal to 4. Now we can return to the original variable x. We get x cubed equal to minus 1 or x cubed equal to 4. We then take cube roots and find x equal to minus 1 or x equal to the cube root of 4, which I cannot really simplify. I cannot give you a general rule that tells you when to use which technique. This is a matter of practicing a lot, so make sure you have a look at the exercises. Once you have reduced your equation to a simple equation, or several simple equations that are standard to solve, solve everything and collect the solutions. As a last step, check your solutions by plugging them back into the original equation. Why? Well, first of all, you may have made errors, and this is the way to detect them. But even if you did not make any mistake, you may have obtained false solutions in your derivation. For example, consider the equation square root of x equal to minus 3. You can square both sides to obtain x equal to 9. This is a legitimate move, but check that x equal to 9 is not a solution of the original equation. What's the mistake here? Well, our derivation tells us that if x is a solution to the first equation, then it is also a solution to the second. But in general, the reverse does not have to be true, and in this case, it isn't. This is not a problem as long as you are aware that the new equations in your derivation may have more solutions than the first one, and you can easily identify the false solutions by simply checking. I hope that by watching this video, you have an idea of useful techniques and common mistakes when it comes to solving equations. But the best way to learn it is by lots of practice. So good luck with the exercises.